Hi guys, welcome to Sugar MD channel. This is Dr. Ahmet Ergin, and today I am talking to you about the worst breakfast ideas. Now, when I'm at the clinic, I see my patients with this beautiful Dexcom and Libre results, and their blood sugars are always spiking after breakfast. And I always ask the question, what do you eat? Well, I'll tell you what they eat and why that happens. Let's get started. Guys, I'm Dr. Ahmet Ergin. I'm an endocrinologist and a diabetes expert. Today we are talking about the worst diabetes ideas, breakfast ideas. So, if you live in the United States, you're doomed. I'm just kidding. But in the United States, the breakfast we have for Americans sucks. It's full of carbs. Okay, no wonder why we have so much diabetes. Now, in Mediterranean countries, in Italy, in Turkey, and Greece, you know, nice. They have good breakfast, although not always the best. They have their own, downsides too. But in the United States, we have horrible, horrible breakfast. Here's the number one. Cereal. Like, what other nation in the world eats cereal for breakfast? I don't know any other nation, except Americans. And I don't know who invented the cereal, but it's the worst invention ever. So they can claim whatever they want on the advertisement, heart healthy, this healthy, that healthy. They're not healthy for you. They're full of carbs. They spike your blood sugar very fast. There is no medication that can hold your blood sugar down when you eat cereal, my friend, even if insulin. When I give you insulin, that thing starts working in like 15, 20 minutes and it peaks in 90 minutes, even the fast acting insulin. When you eat cereal, your blood sugar is already up like at the max in 15, 20 minutes. So by the time the insulin kicks in, your cereal is already spiked you. So game is over, done. So by eating cereal, you cannot really help it unless you want to take your insulin like 45 minutes before and risk for going low before having your cereal. But you don't want to play these risky games. So cereal is out. You know, what can you do, you know, if you're not gonna have cereal? Well, you can have chia pudding, okay? So you can soak some chia pudding in some nice milk overnight. That's gonna be, and put some fresh fruit in there. It's gonna be awesome. You can do the same thing for oats. You can soak oats, or you can do like, not the quick ones, not the quick oats or rolled oats. You wanna go for steel cut oats. You can use a pressure cooker. You can use soaking overnight, and you can use some fresh fruit on top, and there you go. You have a delicious breakfast that's like way, way better than your cereal. Number two, I would say your flavored yogurts. I always tell people eat yogurt, and they always go pick up the worst yogurt on the shelf. Why? Because they want it to taste better. Well, I get that. But the problem with the flavored yogurts, there's so much added sugar in there that defeats the purpose. You have to have real yogurt. I don't care if you're going for a full-fat yogurt. That's fine if you want to get some creamy taste. But you want to make sure that you put real fruit on top of the yogurt if you cannot handle normal yogurt. But to me, actually, to be honest with you, for me, you know, having some nuts and some fruit on the yogurt at the breakfast is the best breakfast, especially after you have this sweaty cardio that you feel hot inside. You know, instead of grabbing a Coke or something, have this cold yogurt with some nice toppings on it that are fresh and healthy. Now, what else? The third horrible breakfast idea is pancakes and French toast. Now, you're gonna say French toast is not American, French founded. You know what? Actually, French toast that the French make is a little different than what we do in the United States. I had one time I had a real French toast, and I was like, that doesn't taste like our French toast. But the bottom line is, French toast and the pancakes are just fully carbs. And on top of that, what we do, we add some syrup on top of it, some honey, you name it. That's like absolute suicide for a diabetic. So you don't wanna do that. Even if you're not diabetic, come on, it just doesn't make sense just eating and just, you know, dumping some carbs to your stomach. Not a good idea whatsoever. So please, please stay away from pancakes and French toast. Now, the fourth thing that I want you to avoid is smoothies. A lot of people end up doing some smoothies thinking that it's healthy for you, juicing, da 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 da. Well, it adds up. So when you start adding this banana in there, you start adding some other, you know, God knows what you're doing in those smoothies. But when you mix and blend some things, you know, you just don't even see what you're eating. And unless you're really counting what you're really putting in there in terms of the carbs, you will lose your count. And the problem with smoothies is, since they're liquidy, they will be absorbed very quickly, unless you put some avocado in there, some protein powder, some more fat, that will slow the absorption. But anything that's liquid is absorbed fast, and you want the breakfast to hold you longer. So it's better to have some a hearty, solid food at your breakfast than just having some juice. And most people end up rushing those things and not pay attention, and that ends up spiking blood sugar more even. Now, the last but not least is the fruit juice. Now, you're not going to believe that I have some patients who will happily acknowledge and confirm that they eat a pancake, they put syrup on top of it, and they have it with orange juice. And I'm like, okay, I'm out of the room. I'm done. I mean, no, I don't do that. But the bottom line is, how can you really do that to yourself, even when you're not diabetic and expect to be healthy? Because remember, we talked about the juice. Juice is something processed. Their fibers are taken away. I have no problem with real fruit. There are some quacks out there who will prohibit you from eating all sorts of fruits. Well, that's their loss. And if you're following them, that's your loss. But the real fruits are really good for you as long as you're not doing it excessively. So why would you not have orange instead of orange juice? What is in orange juice? Really, there's nothing but sugar. You can have real fruits, real berries, apple, peaches, pears, whatever you like. You can have a half of a portion or a portion that is like 15-20 grams of carbs at your breakfast. It is much better than fruit juice. Again, but sometimes when you prohibit things too much, when you say to people, oh, fruits is bad, this is bad, that bad, the people say, whatever, you know what, screw this, I'll do whatever I want. We don't want people to behave like that. So you can still have a life, and you can learn how to make small adjustments and still control your diabetes. And one of the things that you can learn is not to juice things. So do not drink any fruit juice. Stick with the real fruit. I hope that helps you guys. And if it does, please give a thumbs up, share, and like. And we'll see you in the next video. Hey guys, I hope you're enjoying this channel so far, and I hope you subscribed already. If you didn't, do it. And if you did, watch this video right there. I think that will help you too.